So speaking of knowing, we're the First Alert weather team now, and the goal is, and our pledge, when we know new weather information, you're going to know as well. So we have a lot to talk about tonight, especially with regard to the potential nor'easter as we head into Friday and Saturday. Of course, I'll cover what's going on right now and the quiet weather as we head into the middle of the week, but it does look fairly tricky as we make our way into Friday and Saturday. Current temps, we're in the 20s and 30s, folks. 30 degrees at BWI, Thurgood Marshall Airport. By the way, we made it close to 50 today, right around 2 o'clock this afternoon. So that was a nice little thaw, especially considering the cold is settling back in once again. This Arctic air, it just feels like it's been here to stay. We only got just a brief little break today. Now, overnight, we fall into the low 20s by 4 a.m., but it's going to be feeling like the teens when you factor in the wind chill. And that's also going to be the case at the bus stop as well. So we're looking at temps in the low 20s at the bus stop in the morning. Again, feeling like the teens. It'll be a colder start compared to what we dealt with out there today, in a chilly afternoon with temperatures not making it above freezing. So be prepared. That means once again, you're going to have to dress the kids when they head off to school in the full winter gear, and they're going to need it pretty much all day long. It's just going to be a chilly day, and the chill sticks around. High pressure moving into control. That is going to keep us quiet through the middle of the week, also on Thursday as well, but all bets are off by the time we make it to Friday and Saturday. I'll be tracking an area of low pressure developing off the coast of the Carolinas. Depending on its track, it could bring some pretty significant impacts to the eastern seaboard. So let's talk about those potential tracks, and we have been discussing these throughout the day today. A track closer to the coast, especially if this low moves right over Cape Hatteras, that's going to be the track for some Baltimore snow lovers. I can tell you that much. But a track farther out offshore, that's going to bring us lower totals across the metro and less of an impact. So what are we talking about snow total wise? Well, if it hugs the coast, parts of the eastern shore could actually end up getting pretty hammered. I'm not totally sold on this model solution yet, because there are other models that signal maybe just a moderate snowfall possible with light accumulations in the metro. This is still something we are going to have to fine tune over the coming days. And I think tomorrow, once we get a look at the higher resolution models, we'll have a much better idea of what you can expect, and we'll perhaps be issuing an alert day as we head into Friday as well as Saturday. Saturday cold, blustery. It could feel sub-zero. We'll be right back.